Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Hope you're doing good. So before I start, let me tell you that a few days back I had uploaded another video of user testing, the link of which you can find in the description box. In that video, I have answered almost all the questions that might come to your mind before registering yourself with user testing. And I have also shown the proof of my payment receipts there, so don't forget to check that out after this one. And I would be very happy if you subscribe to my channel for more videos and for my encouragement. Thanks. So let's begin with today's video. This whole procedure of becoming a test participant is in two parts. So please don't miss out on any part or any steps. Let's see the first part. To be a tester, type user testing on Google. Let's open this first link. Now on this page, you can see on top, get paid to test. Please click on this option. As you're new here, you need to register yourself first. For that, you have to enter your email address here. Now tick this box that says I have read and agree with the terms of use and our privacy policy. And then click on apply. Now open your emails and find out user testing's email for verification. So this is the email I have received from user testing. Let me open this. Now click here on this blue box and it's done. Now this is a short video which you should watch to know what you need to do during the test. You can skip this by clicking on the skip button, but I would suggest you watch it as it gives you an idea of how this works. Now click on the next button and wow, you're now ready to take the practice test. So here is another very important video which gives you some important tips to be a good participant. So basically the 5 tips are: you need to record in a quiet and distraction free place, describe the scenario that you have been given for the test, complete each task before moving on to the next and don't miss out on any task, then speak your thoughts out loud, don't be quiet during the test, and lastly ask questions and add comments. That's it. Now click on start your test. Again, this is a very important part if you're a beginner, so read the instructions and keep following them. So you need to click on this arrow to minimize it. After giving it a try, click on the next step. Now put your cursor on the corner of this widget to drag it wherever you want. Next step, speak out loud to check the mic. Next, close all the unwanted tabs that you don't want to be recorded. Once done, click on the start recording. Next, you need to share your screen. So click on this box to select it and then click on the start button here. This is the scenario of this test which you need to read loudly and make sure you understand it before moving on to this first task. Let's have a closer look at the scenario. And this red dot means the recording has started. So this test is about planning a trip to the Air and Space Museum. Alright, let's start. So this is the website that you'll be testing today. I've hidden the name of the website to avoid any issues with the customer. So do not be quiet at any time. Speak up whatever is going on in your mind. Let's click on start. Click on begin this step and do as the task says. In the same way, you need to complete all the tasks given to you. When you have completed all the tasks, share your final thoughts about the test. And then you can stop the recording by clicking here. Then you might have to answer a few questions in written form, but not all tests require that. When done, click on finish test and wait for it to get uploaded. Don't close the tab until it's done. Now when it's successfully uploaded, you may close the test. Let me do it. Okay, here the first part is completed. Okay, now I received this email which says that my application is being reviewed. So the very next day of this email, I received another email, this one, which says I have been accepted as a test participant. So this is where a second part of registration begins. So receive this email, the main part. Okay, in the first part, you just entered your email address and took your practice test, but didn't complete the whole form, which you're gonna do now. So to register yourself and your PayPal account to receive your payments, you need to click here to create your account. Let's do it. It's written here that user testing will use your information only to get you suitable tests that match your demographics and not for any other purpose. Okay, so you need to fill in your first name here, your last name here, then create your username. So it would be better if you choose a name that doesn't match yours. Please read this before creating your username. If you don't want to hide your identity, it's totally fine. Now create a password as you do for any website. Here you have to fill in your postal code and then your PayPal email ID. If you don't know how to create a PayPal account, then please don't forget to watch my next video. So do subscribe. Okay, so after filling in all these details, click here on continue. After this, you need to complete your profile. What devices do you own? You can fill in all that you have, like Windows PC, Mac, iPhone, Android phone, tablet, iPad, etc. Then what social networks are you on, like FB, Insta, Twitter, and all those that you use. Now you will start seeing tests once your profile is complete. Simple as that. So this is the whole procedure, and now you should start receiving screeners. So screeners are a few multiple choice questions that you need to answer before you are able to accept a test. They can be about your employment experience, likes and dislikes, shopping habits, hobbies, or something else entirely. Okay, so available tests are shown here. Your completed test will be shown here. Now make sure you keep your profile updated. Then you can check your messages here if you receive any from the customers. And from here, you can check FAQs and contact support center. I usually email them directly from my Gmail. You can also check out your pending payments here for the whole week and sign out from here. And also your ratings will be shown here, which you'll receive from the customers, which is the average of your last 12 completed tests. So now I want to show you my first test. Here it is. I received this review from User Testing. Let's zoom in. You can see I received 4 out of 5 stars on my first test, which is not bad. So here they have explained why I didn't get 5 out of 5 stars and what I can do to improve for my future test. Here's another test where I was asked to book a train trip from London to Paris. If you know how to book a ticket online, then you can easily do this test. If you have no idea of how to do that, please don't accept the test, as if the customer gets to know that you lied during the screener, then they might not pay you. So please accept only those tests for which you are suitable match, and always be honest. Don't just accept any random test for the sake of money. So these were the tasks that I was supposed to complete for this test. As you can see, they are very simple questions that I had to answer while booking the trip, and nobody is judging me on the basis of how good I'm doing that. I have to do this as naturally as possible and speak out loud whatever is going on in my mind, even if I feel I'm being stupid. Seriously, nobody's checking your IQ level here. They're testing their website with your help to get to know the user experience from different point of view. So now, as we have seen how this works, let's move on to the review part. You won't receive a review for all your tests, but some customers leave their review for you if they like your feedback a lot, and even sometimes if they don't like it at all, in case you were of no help to them. But this rarely happens. So this was my first review. You'll definitely receive your first review where they explain what you did good and how you can improve if there were any mistakes on your part. Here I haven't received any review but 5 stars, so if you get it too, be happy. Here 4 stars, again 5 here, but mostly there are no ratings at all. Let's look at this one for which my payment became void. Means I didn't receive any money for this, although I completed it. The reason for this is that the customer didn't find my feedback helpful and user testing team too. But because this was my first time, so they didn't want to give me low ratings for this and decided to return the money to the customer instead of paying it to me. To be honest, even I wasn't satisfied with my performance on this test, so I had no problem receiving no money. But I didn't want my average rating to go down, which was actually 4.8 stars at that time. So yeah, I was fine with getting no money for this test. Anyway, this happened only once. So that's all for today. If you have any questions, please let me know in the comment section. And please share this video with others who might benefit from this. And give it a thumbs up if you like it. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching. Take care.